Hello friends, welcome to my channel all about solars and the soul of all energy. In my last video, I get query about that how to import the SketchUp drawing in PVC. Though I have shown that thing that if you use the Skillion Pro version and by using the PVC tab in Skillion, you can convert your SketchUp drawing in .h2p file and you can import that same. If you not watch that video, please go to the card. Now our concern is that if we don't have that Skillion Pro version, so in that case what I will do? I don't have the Pro version of Skillion, I have only the trial version. So by using this trial version, how I can import the SketchUp drawing in PVCist? So before wasting any time, let's get started. Before going to the explanation, first of all we need to understand, if you draw the SketchUp drawing in a conventional way, like if you draw the module as a rectangle, that means here you can see these modules are rectangle and group, each group having two modules, but here you consider these rectangles as solar module. When you export this drawing and import it to PVCist, PVCist will not be able to understand whether this module is 325 or 330. That means PVCist don't have the identity of this module. These are the rectangles for PVCist. So first of all, we have to identify this module. For this identify purpose, we have to use the Skillion. Okay, so now I am just giving you an example that if I export this drawing. So now for the exporting purpose, you can click on export and click on the 3D model. So here a file format you find .3ds, that means 3D shading scene or 3D scene, and I am just exporting it in. Okay, so as you can see, the export has been done. Now I am opening up the PVCist. Now I am going to import the 3D scene here. File, import 3ds. So here h2p. So as you can see, after importing your drawing, this type of window will come up. So if you consider particular module, then in PV objects the module will be shown here. But here there is no module has been mentioned because we consider rectangle as a module. Scene details, if you just convert it in millimeter, and then you can see that this is the actual scene, and now this is actually orientation is different. If I just change the orientation, scene origin 180 degree. Now this is basically the drawing. If we now close the scene and go to the outside window, then you can see that no settings defined for this simulation, as this drawing don't have any kind of proper module. So that's why PVCist will not be understand that which type of module or what is the modules we have used in near shading drawing. So that's why we can't use this one. So for that purpose, there is two way. The first way is the, when you start the drawing, just make a rectangle, consider it as face, click on insert solar components, and here I am just using PV database, change the database, maximum number of modules, let's say I am considering it as 2 and stack component as 2, and let's say continue. So in that case you will find this 2 modules. At the start of your drawing, you just take these 2 modules and draw accordingly. And another process, as I already discussed previously, you just replace those modules with the Skillion modules, as I have done it here. I replace those rectangle modules with the Skillion modules. As I replace the drawing with Skillion modules, now I am going to export it again, 3D model, and I'm just going to export this one. So now I have exported the drawing in 3ds file. Now again go to the PVCist and go to the file, import 3D scene SketchUp training. open. Here you can see, if you go to the PV objects, as you can see, I have considered the module as Adani Solar module. So that's why that the name is come up, Adani Solar. So if you just click on it and click on OK, so you can just see that the drawing has been come up. Now there are some problem. Now first thing is, when you import any kind of drawing from .3ds file to PVSys, then in that case the orientation is different. So first of all, you have to change the scene origin. You have to go to the azimuth and click on scene origin and consider the azimuth as 180 degree. So you can see the drawing has been converted in a proper manner. That means it's converted to from south to north. Now there is another type of problem will come up. If you just close the scene, then you can find there is a error that PVSys will show. Table row 2, column 4 is confused or very close to the object 84. This is a different type of problem. Table row 2, column 4, this one, and the object 84. So here is the problem. When we consider the solar module, the module have a depth of 35 mm or 40 mm. What is the depth? Due to that depth, every module having two portions. The outer one, here PVSys consider the outer one as table row, and the inner one or inner side, which is red marked here, considered as object 84. So we have to delete those internal objects or internal rectangles to free from this error. Now for that reason, what you need to do, I have to find out from where the solar object is started. 29, it's a circle. 33, from 33 it's basically started. So here we have to delete those external rectangles which is inside the modules. So here first of all we have to find out that up to which object the solar modules are there. Let's say click on 256, there is something else. 254, there is something else, it's not a solar module. So up to 252 the modules are there. Now what I will do, I will just select from 111 to just up to, let's say I'm here selecting. So you can find out this, these are the objects what you have selected. Delete. So now you can just cross check it. That means every module are rectangle here. Now this thing is coming up because of the depth. Okay. So now you can close the scene. So now you can see here, the warning table has been cleared and you can compute the system. So according to the computation, the value is coming up as diffuse factor is 0.027 and the albedo factor is 0.04. Now you can ask me that why to do this kind of lots of things, why to delete those objects. If you don't want to delete those objects, there is also a way. In that case, again you have to go to the SketchUp. You have to create a module. Go to the edit user database and let's say Adani Solar model ASP330, length is 1960 and width is 992. Here I am putting the thickness as 0. Okay, now why I am putting it 0, you will understand this. Now here the power rating as 330 watt peak and the weight as 24 kg. Now let's just mention the length. Okay, now crystalline silicon, solar takes 2, and save the panel. So here I have saved the panel and click this face and insert the module. So the first one is here, I am choosing the ASP. Okay, and considered it as first set of module having 10 number of modules. So put that 10, stack component as 2, continue. Again I have to replace those rectangle modules with these modules. Now why to replace with these modules, I will let you know. And again select, all the things will be remain same. but the number of modules is for the next second one it is become 12, and here it is stack component as 2, and click on continue. So again this one, now I will delete those rectangle modules again what I have shown in my last scalion video. So I am doing here the thing is same, but here you can see one thing, the module don't have any kind of depth. The benefit of this will come up during the PVSyst, like when you import the drawing in PVSyst, then you will understand. Now I have, you can see from the backwards, I have just replaced the rectangle modules with the scalion modules, but these modules don't have any kind of depth. Okay, that 35 mm depth what we generally consider, but these modules don't have any kind of depth. Now what is the benefit of it? Now what I will do, I will export it again, go to the file, export 3D model, and export it SketchUp training module without thickness. Now export it. Yes. Okay, the exporting has been done. Now go to the construction and just delete the previous one. And here what I will do, again the go to the file, import 3ds. So here SketchUp training module without thickness, select it, open. Now here when you have done the drawing in SketchUp, so it is generally in millimeter, so just consider it millimeter, because x, y, z value is become too high, so you have to consider it as millimeter, so it's become fine. Now go to the PV objects. As you can see here, the Adani Solar module has come up, so just click on OK, so the module will be come up. Now I am just selecting it and go to the modify and go to the scene origin and rotate it 180 degree. As here all the modules are just single rectangle, there is no depth. You just render it, you will see the things, and just if you just close the scene, so you can see here in this case you no need to do anything with the objects or delete the objects, as you have considered only normal rectangles. There is no inner rectangles between these single rectangles, so that's why you no need to do with anything with the objects. This is a process when you do the design, so just use a scalion or just try to use the scalion module with the depth or thickness is zero. So if you just consider the thickness is zero, when you exported that drawing in SketchUp or 3ds file and you import that same drawing in PVSyst, then PVSyst will consider those rectangle as solar module and there will be no inner objects there. So this is the basic process, and close the scene. You can just go to the table and compute it now, and I think you can see the diffuse factor and albedo factor is almost same. Always remember, when you import the SketchUp drawing in PVSyst, you have to use the scalion module bar, at least the insert component. This insert component bar you have to use. You have to use the modules from the scalion only, then PVSyst will understand that this is the solar module. That's all about today's one. Thanks for watching. If you think this video is helpful for you, please share it with your friends, and please subscribe to my channel for more tutorial of solar power plant. Thank you.